Well, hi-de-ho there again, boys and girls, and welcome to yet another edition of Live from the Tape Farm. Today we are going to be standing on the shoulders of giants. A gentleman by the name of Dan Thompson has a YouTube channel by the name of Guns and Guitars, which is a channel that I regularly watch. He does all sorts of budget guitar builds, how to get the most out of your gear type stuff for not a lot of money type stuff. Right up my alley. So, he did an episode recently where he was walking through his local craft store and found something called a bee brood box. Say that five times fast. A bee brood box. What it is, it's a box that you use to make beehives. He looked at it and said, wow, this looks about the same size as a 112 cabinet. And it was a solid pine box. And he thought, heck, I'll make a 112 cabinet out of it. And he made a video of it. And I have the link to that video in the description below. I would highly suggest you go not only watch that video, but all of Dan's videos, because they're really good, really well done. But that video in particular, if you're interested in what we're doing here today, you'll want to watch that video first, because it goes into a lot of the details that I don't go into here, because I didn't feel the need to repeat what Dan did. He did a very good job of explaining what he was doing in the video. No need for me to repeat that. Go watch his video so you'll get to the basics. So what are we doing here today? We, again, are standing on the shoulders of giants. He made a 112 speaker cabinet out of that box. I bought the box. I was like, oh, I'm going to do that. I'm going to make a 112 speaker box. He had a link in his video to the store where you could buy the box. I sent away. It was $20 for the box kit. Picture here. So I got it and I started building it as if I was going to build a 112 speaker cabinet. From the beginning, as I was building it, I had no intentions of making a video, because I'm like, why should I make a video of something that somebody already made a video of? That's silly. But then as I started doing it, I was like, I think I could make this a combo amp. And that would be kind of cool. That would be different. So that's what I did. I have an Epiphone Valve Junior, which I really like. These are amps that are tons of people have modified them. There's links all over the internet with like tons of different mods you can do. I personally haven't modded the amp at all, other than I replaced the preamp tube. It had some cheap, non-branded Chinese tube in there, and I put a Softec preamp tube in there. Other than that, that's the only mod I did. I put a different tube in the preamp section. I'd always thought, well, eventually I'll get around to doing some mods on this amp, but I thought this would be kind of cool, so let me do this first. Let me make it a combo amp, because one of the things the Tape Farm has here is not a whole heck of a lot of room. And I have a little amp room right over here. When I say little amp room, I'm not kidding. It's tiny. It's not big. It's basically about 3 feet wide by about 6.5, 7 feet deep that I keep my amps in one end of it. And then I have that space to mic things up as I want to. I thought it'd be kind of cool to make that a combo amp, because I had a 212 cabinet that I had the head hooked up to and taking up a lot of room that I don't have. If I make this a combo amp, heck, I could get more gear, right? I could buy another amp because now I have room for it. So, so the motivation for doing all this, of course, is, you know, more gear. Why wouldn't you do that? Where I started recording the video was where I had gotten to the point where I said, okay, I think I'm gonna make this a combo amp. So that's where we are. That's where this video now will take off from. All right, well, the time has come to make a decision. I got my baffle all made and smoothed out and made it all nice and pretty. Got some burlap outside I'm gonna use as a speaker grill. Got the bee box all assembled and shaped. Still have one little nail hole or screw hole here that I need to sand down with some filler. But it's all nice. Corners are all nice and rounded. Back is all assembled and ready to go. So now I have to make a decision. Do I keep this a speaker box? And I have a nice little 12-inch Eminence speaker I was going to put in. do I keep it a speaker box or do I make it a combo amp? So I think I'm going to bite the bullet. I think I'm going to make this a combo amp. I think I'm going to take the innards from my Epiphone Valve Junior here and install it inside this box. And I think I'm going to call it the B-Box Deluxe. So there you go. So let's have at it. Let's see what we can do here. All right. So the first thing I had to do was mount the speaker in there so I could see how much room I'm going to have to put the amp. I think I'm going to have to turn this thing on its, what is now its side. So like something like that. And, and put the amp in up here in one of the ends. But let's see. All right. Possible change of plans. So even if I were to put the controls out front, you know, like, you know, make the controls, put the amp in this way and the controls, the input and the volume would be on the front of the amplifier, which is, I'm not generally opposed to that. It's just, you know, it would be a little bit cooler if it were on the side somewhere or something along those lines. But even with the way it is right now, this amp won't fit in there. That transformer hits the speaker and it's just not going to work. So that leads to my next thing, is plan B, which is take this guy, which was going to be the back, make it the front, cut the speaker down here, down towards the bottom, and then the amp can be here, giving it more room. All right, so here's what I've come up with. I think I'm gonna go with the idea of making this kind of an upright combo. So this area would have the amp, down here would have the speaker. So now I'm just figuring out exactly where I'm gonna be cutting the hole for the speaker. So I've cut the space for the amp to show through on the front. Kind of beveled the edges here with the router bit. And obviously it's upside down. So let me help you out. More like that. So I had an idea for the back, basically to make the access hole for the amp the same style as the front. So the way I did that, obviously, is just I just removed the front of the head that the amp came out of, and I'm just using it as a template. So, boom. So now I'll just cut that out and then have access to all the different connections on the back of the amp. Ta-da! So, or, here you go. Ta-da! So the next step would be to drill the holes for the amp, like to mount the amp. I thought what I might try is I just basically put the screws in to the holes that they go into, and I colored the top of them with a Sharpie, and then kind of put it in place and kind of pressed down, and it left little black marks where the tops of the screws were, and then I just took my Sharpie and just kind of etched, you know, made a little mark as far as how big the hole is going to be, but essentially mark the top of the screw, push it down into the wood, leaves a little black so you have a guide. And voila, so screws on top there. Now one of the things you want to make sure when you're drilling through that, that you're using a really good drill bit and you don't press hard.
this pine is really soft and it will tear out very easily. So to save yourself from having to do some patching, just go slow and let the drill bit do the work, as my dad always used to tell me. And I just started listening, 50 years later. So I thought I might want to use this Epiphone nameplate, maybe put it on here somewhere. I don't know, but just in case. I'm going to see if I can't take this out. Basically, what I'm thinking of doing is just taking this thin little screwdriver and just kind of pounding it through there and see if I can't just make that little logo pop out there. And there we go, easy as can be. So it popped out fairly easy. One of the little tabs broke off there, one of the little arms, but I'll just glue that back on there. Alrighty, so we're gonna try this with my Les Paul, little Epiphone Les Paul with the P90s. Let's give this a shot here. We'll go 10 o'clock, more or less. I think it's time to do some final sanding and staining and making it look pretty. But yeah. And we'll get some better sound samples too when we do the final rundown. Obviously through the iPhone mic, it's probably not the best in the world. But we'll mic it up proper at the end here when we do a final test. So unlike Dan with his speaker cabinet, he made the front removable just so he can get the speaker in and out easy, which makes a lot of sense. But who am I to make sense of things? So I'm actually going to glue my front baffle in, glue and screw it actually, and I'll show you what screws I'm using. And just like Dan, I use tight bond wood glue. It is about the best wood glue there is out there. Every video I've ever seen of people gluing things together with wood on YouTube, they're using tight bond. So who am I to argue with all these people, all these other videos that I watch? So let me show you these screws here. So these are things you can get at Lowe's, Home Depot, places like that. But they're a very they're a trim screw. So I've also seen them called cabinet maker screws and things like that. They're they have a very small head that has a hex bit that you use, and it comes with one. And so self-tapping cut there that you can see, hopefully. And it leaves a very small hole that's very easy to patch. So here's kind of what you end up with here. So they countersink themselves, and basically you just put a little bit of wood filler inside those holes. They ain't going anywhere. All right, next step for me is just doing the inside of the amp black. Just a little touch. I just like the inside of the inside of amps to be black. Totally unnecessary, but just something I wanted to do. I taped around the edges there. You can see the blue painter's tape because the outside is all going to be stained. So I didn't want to get any black paint on the outside wood. So there we go. So inside all painted black and ready to go. So I put one coat of stain on. This is the back, and just want to see how it looked. That's turning out pretty good. I don't know if you can hear them in the background, but our pigs are making all sorts of noise. You know, I've never actually shown you guys the farm. I mean, it's called the tape farm, but it's a tape farm for a reason. A little bit. I'm gonna do two different stains. I'm gonna do a lighter stain on the front and the back and a darker stain on the box itself. Not sure how that's gonna work out, but I'm gonna give it a shot, and if it works, great. If it doesn't work, we'll know that too. So here we go. All right, and there's the front all stained and ready for drying. I probably should have gotten a better brush because I'm seeing little hairs all inside here. So let that be a lesson to you. A good craftsman doesn't blame his tools unless craftsman gets crappy tools. All right, sides are now painted using a horse feed bag on top of the horse feed bag. So going with a lighter color on the front baffle with a darker color all the way around, and turned out pretty good. All right, so it's a bright and sunny morning here in the greater Nashville area, and I've been toying with a couple of ideas here. So this is kind of what the box ended up looking like, and to be honest with you, I'm not really pleased with that. I wanted it to be darker, darker than the front, but I just didn't like the way it turned out. So I thought, well, maybe I'll sand it down a little bit. So I sanded it down a little bit and then put a little bit of finishing wax on it. And I'm kind of liking the way that looks. I really am. I'm kind of liking the way that, so I think I might sand down the sides a little, throw some wax on there, almost kind of distress it a little bit. But we'll see how it turns out. All right, so that's with these two sides done. So that's kind of like the after, the before. Now, if from a distance, this doesn't look horrible, but like up close, it just doesn't look good. I think I put on too much of that stain, which is kind of like an all-in-one stain and finish kind of product. So I think I just applied it too thick because I was trying to get it as dark as I could. First coat looked okay. Second coat just, after a while, it just didn't look very good. This, I'm kind of digging. And that finishing wax really helps it out. All right, Chase is coming along, and I put some burlap in there for a speaker grill. And that turned out really nice. So looking good there. I got these off of Amazon. You got handle, and I got some corners. But these are all very new looking. So let me say we beat them up a little bit. And there we go, just a little bit. Yeah, just a little, scratch them up a little bit. Yeah. Yeah, make them look like they've been there for a little while. I did countersink the screws to put in to hold the amp in. So let's look at these corners. All right, to be honest with you, I don't know. I don't know that I even like them. I think these are like $5 for a whole set, so it's not like I'm out a ton of money. But I'm not even sure that I like them on there. Last but not least is some feet, which I actually pulled off the old head and just put those on there. I guess the last finishing touch is to put this guy on here. Just thinking about putting it like right there, like that, more or less. So I used the same trick I used to mark where to put the screws to put the amp in, is to just put a little Sharpie on the ends of these posts and then mark right where they are so I know where to drill. And there we go. So just about done. Now I just need to clean this place up and shoot a video for you guys. So let's get a little drum loop going and see what we come up with. Got my old early 80s Squire Made in Japan Stratocaster. Got the humbucker turned on this one, and let's see what we can do with this one. There you have it. With the B-Box Deluxe Combo Amp. Sounding pretty decent. I may end up doing some modifications to it down the road. Some electronic modifications, maybe change out a speaker. Who knows? We'll see. It definitely sounds better in the amp room than it did out here on the counter. I think that has to do with the distance between the wall and the back of the amp. Sounds good in there. Thanks for watching. If you happen to be passing through, go ahead and like and subscribe to The Tape Farm if you don't mind. Also, check out Dan's channel, Guns and Guitars. A lot of great content on his channel. Really cool place to get ideas of things you might wanna tackle yourself. So anyway, that's it for today. Thanks for watching.
Hey folks, thanks for watching. The Tape Farm specializes in analog to digital transfers of many prosumer tape formats. From standard cassettes up to 16-channel multi-track recordings, we specialize in formats from manufacturers like Tascam, Fostex, Alesis, and others. So if you have some old tapes in your closet that you'd like to get converted to digital files that can be loaded into your DAW of choice to either relive or remix the past, send them on to us. You can check us out at thetapefarm.com.